Survivors of the Black Summer bushfires of 2019-2020 have slammed the inquiry into the disaster. A coroner has made dozens of recommendations for our rural fire service, but there are claims tonight it's a missed opportunity.
Never before had we seen a bushfire season of this scale and ferocity. For 240 days, our state burned, and 4 years on, the scars are still raw.
Our community was terrorised by 10 days. It was 10 days of trying to survive.
25 lives were lost and more than 2,400 homes destroyed. From the outset, the coroner made clear this two-year inquiry wasn't about laying blame or liability, but for victims of the Mount Wilson blaze in the Blue Mountains, which was sparked by a backburn, the report provides cold comforts.
Nothing about hazard reduction, nothing about killing all the animals, nothing about compensation for all the people who lost so much.
Trust has been eroded, essentially, sort of faith in institutions.
The coroner made 28 recommendations, of which 25 were directed at the Rural Fire Service, including the need for improved training and warning systems, better communication and risk evaluation, greater information for water bombing pilots and improved vehicle safety after 7 firefighters lost their lives. Those on the ground who fought for their lives and homes claim the issue was decisions were coming out of a centralised command.
The real problem is a top-heavy bureaucratic RFS, not volunteers, we respect them. The bureaucracy administering from a lovely air-conditioned office.
The local captains need to be listened to more.
Strategies on firefighting are never done from state operations. They're always done locally.
Very few bushfire victims were in court today. Many are still too traumatised, others too busy, still trying to rebuild their homes. But the overwhelming feeling is this inquiry has achieved nothing. What the victims want is an independent body to analyse disasters to ensure the horrors that unfolded 4 years ago never happen again.
We're on the rim of the Sydney Basin. We stop the fire coming into you. All we're asking is to listen to our stories so that we can be better prepared.
At Lidcombe, Sophie Walsh, Nine News.